This teeny tiny plugin actually originated from a question in the comments here under one of my YouTube videos. In this video, I'm going to show you the plugin I made to influence the screen brightness in a .NET MAUI application. That is right. I try to read all the comments under my videos as much as possible, but you know, there is many of you and there's just one of me. So there's only so much I can do in a day. Sorry if I can't get to it all, but I try to read them all and I try to answer as much as possible. And this is actually something that was under one of my videos. A person asked like, hey, how do I influence or how do I get or set the screen brightness in a .NET MAUI application? And that made me think like, there isn't anything really I know of that does this in .NET MAUI. And to be fair, it's very simple to do. It's only a couple of lines of code. So maybe someone has this inside of their project, but I decided to go on a little adventure and see how to make this into a plugin. And I'll show you that in a little bit. But that also was very interesting because this is a very tiny elementary plugin. And it is a perfect example to show you how to get started with .NET MAUI plugins. So if that's something that you're interested in, please let me know down in the comments and I will make a video about creating your own .NET MAUI plugins. I think I'm gonna make two, if you're interested in like one, a more functional one, and one how to make kind of like your custom controls. So which one are you interested in? Are you interested in both? Let me know down in the comments. Now, back to the screen brightness. Actually, let's just go into Visual Studio right away and I'll show you how to work with it. Here I am on Windows Visual Studio 2022. On the left, a file new .NET MAUI application. On the right, you can see my screen mirror on a physical device, a physical Android device, because the demo is going to be a little bit challenging here. The screen brightness can only be seen on a physical device, obviously. So I'm going to see if you can actually see it right here. You probably can a little bit, but you'll get the idea. It's of course much cooler to just get the code out of the repository that's linked down in the video description below and try it yourself. All right, so one thing that I already did is install the NuGet package. So go into your Solution Explorer, right-click on the project, do Manage NuGet Packages. And I have this package, which is called, let me see, where is it? There we go, plugin.maui.screenbrightness. It has a little icon. It is in pre-release right now. I'm still adding platforms that are supported on here right now. That's iOS, Android. I just added Windows just before recording this video, and I'm looking to do Tizen as well. So we got basically all the platforms that will support .NET MAUI as well. Mac Catalyst, Mac OS, I've tried it. It doesn't really work, so I'm not sure if it can work for Mac OS on a laptop, but you know, for all the other platforms. I think this mostly makes sense for iOS and Android anyway. Install this plugin, version 1.0.0 preview 3 at the time of recording, and you're set to go. You don't need to do any initialization. Actually, you don't need any permissions to do this, at least not right now, so you can just get started. I set it up basically as the .NET MAUI Essentials API, so you have kind of like the static way of using it, or you can do it with dependency injection. So let's see how to register it for dependency injection. Go to your MAUI program, and here you can say services.add, and you can do it as a singleton in this case, add singleton, and you can say, hey, I want to register this screen brightness dot, and you will have to have the right using statement here. So let's IntelliSense help us. And using not the Android provider, but plugin.maui.screenbrightness. And I have this dot default. So that's the default instance. You can just register it like this. And you also have the iScreenBrightness that you can now inject inside of your application. So that's one way to actually do it. I'll leave it in here. Use with dependency injection just for reference in the sample code. I'm just going to use the static one, which is much easier. So let's go over to, well, the XAML first. I'm going to remove this waving.net bot, and what I'm going to do is add a slider in here. So let's do a slider, and let's give that a name so I can reference it. Slider brightness, something like that. And actually, I'm gonna leave it at that for now. I'm just gonna build it out as we go and add a little label on top of that. And I'm also going to give that a name is label brightness, right? So we have those two, and now I can have some fun with that. So I have these two, and what I want to do actually is first set the slider value so that we have the initial value to whatever the brightness is at that moment, right? So I'm going to set that to slider brightness dot value, is screen brightness. And this is the other way to use it, right? Screen brightness. Again, let IntelliSense help us here, or let's just add the using with by hand here, using Plugin.Maui.ScreenBrightness. I'm trying to, the plugins that I'm creating, to go with like the format Plugin.Maui. Whatever the thing is doing. Does that make sense? I think it does. And I can say .default. And it just has one property, basically. So there's no very complicated APIs. You just have this one property, brightness, which is a float. And that will give you the value, or you can set the value. So we set that for the slider. So now we have that initial value. And here we can have that counter clicked. We're going to remove that. We don't have that anymore. And here in our main page, let's add for the slider a value changed event. Create a new event handler. And in that event, we're going to set the actual screen brightness. So I can just copy this one, basically, screen brightness. There is, and then I'm going to say e dot new value. And new value in this case is going to be a double. So it's going to complain here because it needs to be a float. But luckily, we can explicitly convert this, cast this so that it gets there. And we, of course, want to also update our label value. So I can say label brightness dot text is, and let's just take the screen brightness one. I could also take the e new value, right? But that's no fun. We want to see the actual screen brightness coming from the screen brightness APIs on your device, right? So screen brightness dot default dot brightness dot to string, and you probably want to round this because these values are going to be like way behind the comma or dot. So you probably want to add some round, some math dot round somewhere in here. But this should be enough to actually change the brightness of your screen on iOS, Android, Windows, Tizen, hopefully in the near future. So let's see if that works. And our application is coming up. And you can see 0.368, blah, 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 blah. Now you have to watch here. So let me put my finger on it. And if I slide it all the way down, you can see the brightness is going all the way down, right? And if I do it up, it goes all the way up. And it's blinding you. Ah, it's blinding you. So you can go up and down with this slider and you can see the screen brightness is moving over your application. That is how to influence or get the screen brightness in your .NET MAUI application. So again, very simple plugin. I just want you to know that it exists, that it is for you to use. There is one property right now. I hope I can add an event whenever the screen brightness changes so that you can interact with that because you want to do something in your app maybe. I don't know. That would be a cool feature to add. Or of course, if you know how to do it, feel free to open a pull request. The repo link is down below in the video description. And let me know in the comments if this is a nice sample that you want to see as an example on how to get started with your own .NET MAUI plugins, if that's something that you're interested in. For the rest, please like this video if you've enjoyed it, subscribe to my channel, and maybe check out this playlist for more .NET MAUI goodness. This playlist for all the videos that I have on my channel, which has to do with something .NET, C#, and all the crazy things, and I'll be seeing you on the other side.